there, and welcome to The Works. I'm Ben Che.
And I'm Ben Peltier. Later on the show, we'll be the first to hear newly commissioned works for the clarinet by young Hong Kong composers. I'll be talking to members of K622 Clarinet Ensembles to find out more.
According to the Xin An Xian Zhi, an 1819 gazette, the name Pokfulam refers to a species of bird called Pok-fu that was once common in the area. Pokfulam Village has existed since the early 17th century. Today, the same name refers to a much larger neighbourhood that can boast several historic buildings, including the Bethanie, a cluster of properties under the old dairy farm, and Douglas Castle, now the University Hall of the University of Hong Kong. One of those historic buildings, the old dairy farm's senior staff quarters, has now been revitalized as a living museum. Nigel lives in Pokfulam Village. His family has lived here for four generations ever since his great-grandfather settled here in 1889. The village lifestyle and cultural traditions have been maintained through generations. Apart from its traditional houses, Pokfulam Village is known for its long and close connection with the dairy farming history in Hong Kong. A dairy farm was set up in the area by Scottish surgeon Patrick Manson and five businessmen in 1886. The farm, which once stretched from Pokfulam Village to the site of Queen Mary Hospital, employed many villagers to take care of the cattle, imported to provide daily fresh milk.
很多人就會由船廠啊，由太古船廠啊，香港啲船廠就移咗上嚟幫牛奶公司手。都會係成日上山玩啦，同啲牛玩啦，或者係正如有啲人講，朝頭早起身就聽啲牛叫醒咁樣。However,
the dairy farm closed in 1985 as much of the land was taken over for property development. Most of its premises were demolished. Part of the land became the site of Chi Fu Fa Yun, a large private housing estate.
Among
the best preserved of the farm buildings are the senior staff quarters, accorded a Grade 1 status by the Antiquities Advisory Board in 2009. Revitalization of these historical buildings was completed last year. The project's name, the Pokfulam Farm, is written in an ancient form of written Chinese to highlight its long history.
咁就由養牛啦、生產牛奶到生產雪糕咧，其實都係自己即係一個好似自給自足嘅一個故事咁樣。咁我哋覺得依一個開創精神咧，其實無論係以前啦，同埋以至到去而家咧，對香港呢個文化都係一個好重要嘅即係嘅因素。 咁我哋而家身處呢棟建築物咧，其實就係1887年嘅時候起好嘅。咁以前前身就係經理住嘅宿舍啦，同埋一個辦公嘅地方。咁所以我哋呢棟建築物咧，其實就冇一啲好華麗嘅裝飾嘅，咁就係屬於以前一個叫做都铎建築嘅特色啦。下邊咧就有三個牛眼窗。
The new look of Pokfulam Farm was co-designed and is jointly operated by Caritas Hong Kong and the Pokfulam Village Cultural Landscape Conservation Group. Their hope is to bring together the old dairy farm and the culture and history of Pokfulam Village through guided tours, workshops, and exhibitions.
Soft opening 期間咧，其實都有展示唔同嘅一啲有牛奶公司同埋牧場有關嘅收藏品。咁喺左上角呢個咧，其實已經有超過100年歷史㗎啦。我覺得我哋活化計劃同可能其他香港活化計劃唔同嘅地方，就係我哋好注重村民同埋社區參與個部分。咁對佢哋嚟講，呢度好似一個平台咁樣，可以俾佢哋展示佢哋自己嘅文化俾公眾去睇到。咁其實。
One of the community-related works on show in Pokfulam Farm is a project called Familiar Numbers, Unknown Telephone by artist Pak Sheng Chun. In 2005, he gathered a few root numbers he had seen at a Sai Kung bus stop and called them, ending up speaking with a stranger.
我喺巴士站咧，喺一個井蘭樹嘅巴士站咧，見到你個電話號碼。大概過咗10年之後啦，咁我同編輯講咧，喂，不如我哋試下揾翻作品10年後佢而家係點樣樣嘅狀況啦。咁就去揾翻呢個巴士先生咧。10 years later,
after the random call, Pak Sheng Chun finally met the stranger and found out his name was Nigel, and he was a resident of Pokfulam Village. After he visited Nigel's home, they became friends. Recently, Pak Sheng Chun began a community art project in the Pokfulam farm, giving mint plants to visitors as an extension of their story.
嗰啲相就係呢度發生㗎。薄荷葉就喺呢度攞啦。呢度開始引發出嚟。就係佢帶我行咗條村一次啦，帶我去咗薄扶林牧場。另外咧就係咧，我遇到佢爸爸，佢爸爸送咗一棵薄荷葉俾我。 薄荷葉成日都提我一件事嘅就係，喂，我同呢個地方有啲關係。咁我就同阿 Nigel 傾啦，不如我哋將薄荷葉做一個artwork 嚟到去俾其他人去收藏啦，咁樣樣。咁於是我哋就有咗呢個寄養薄荷葉嘅一個計劃咯。因為我哋就將翻呢棵薄荷葉繁殖翻佢好多棵出嚟，就唔同嘅村民同埋出邊嘅人咧，可以嚟到去收養佢啦，形成一個 network 咯。
The encounter of Pak Sheng Chun and Nigel is also part of an M+ community pilot project. Viewers in M+ can sit on villagers' stools to experience the ambience of the village and listen to the recording of Pak Sheng Chun and Nigel's first telephone conversation.
一個人帶我入一條村裏邊，然之後我哋村裏邊咧，我就認識去村裏邊嘅人，將佢哋一齊嚟到去扣埋一齊嚟到做啲創作。即係呢幾年嚟到去同薄扶林村嗰種合作咧，其中一個我覺得最深刻嘅係呢個位咧，就係睇到其實一個社區工作係點樣做咯。咁而你見到嘅，即係薄扶林牧場佢嘅工作咧，通過呢個嘅建築物圍繞嘅故事。 再嚟到聯繫翻村裏邊有嘅故事，跟住將村民帶過嚟咧。其實由佢哋聚合開始，一齊嚟到產生種想像，人同人嘅關係個網絡點嚟到去建立起嚟咧，呢個就係一個作品最核心嘅部分。
Welcome back. Crash and Explore is a pilot project presented by the local group K622 Clarinet Ensembles with the support of the Hong Kong Arts Development Council. That project focuses on developing new compositions and performances as well as larger audiences for the clarinet. 5 recently graduated composers took part in the project, and we now have members of K622 Clarinet Ensembles with us to tell us more.
Tiffany, John, Winnie, and Eric, great to have you here in the studio. You're members of the K622 Clarinet Ensemble. It's not every day we have a clarinet ensemble here in the studio, for sure. Actually, the clarinet really is a family of instruments, isn't it? From really smaller ones like the E-flat clarinet to much larger instruments like the one Eric has there. So maybe you could begin by sort of introducing us to the instrument of the clarinet and the different sizes that it encompasses.
This is the bass clarinet, and normally we will use inside the clarinet ensemble. For the range, is quite wide compared to the normal B-flat clarinet. For the sound, the fingering is more or less is the same, but the sounding pitch is an octave lower. More or less, when we are doing inside the rehearsal, I will play some harmony support with them, and sometimes I will doubling with the melody with the B-flat clarinet.
Right, and actually within the ensemble then, for the concert that you're going to be doing, you don't always stick to this exact lineup. There's at least one composition with 2 bass clarinets, I understand. So is that rather unusual in this format?
Yeah, it's unusual because normally the setting of a clarinet quartet is 3 B-flat with 1 bass or 2 B-flat, 1 middle range instruments like alto clarinet or high register E-flat clarinet. Okay, so 2 B-flat and 2 bass is not a normal setting. Yeah, the composer of the music called Soaking used this component because she tried to build up a different sound of the clarinet ensemble.
Right, yeah. And you've mentioned a different sound for the clarinet ensemble. I think that's a great phrase to jump off into our discussion of the specific program that you've put together and for this upcoming project. Crash and Explore, and then the theme Sky. First of all, where did the theme Sky come from? And then please tell us how you've incorporated the theme Sky into these new compositions for clarinet ensemble.
We come up with the Sky because this is an emerging artist program, okay? For emerging artists, they just graduate. I think what they are going to face about the society, maybe, or their life is a new sky for them. You can, it's a very big topic and free topic that for the composer to compose music.
And for the composers to compose music and for the performers to play this brand new music, that's quite a special experience. Mm-hmm. This program is really special in that it's all brand new music and that you got to work specifically with the composers in putting together the pieces and sort of, you know, co-producing the work that you're going to premiere. So what has that experience been like for you?
Well, I think it's a brand new experience for us because the first thing is we seldom play contemporary music in our ensembles, and we never work we play the pieces with the composers together as well.
I think not only the new composer, there are also Hong Kong local composers too.
Yeah.
After we are working with them around 1 to 2 months, well, we found that all of their works are fascinating. Okay, every music are very different. Maybe for me to introduce some of them. One is the composer Jenny. Okay, she's talking about the experience of this year. She has experience and reflect the society and with her mindset. So it's the music she's composing. And for the pieces Soaking, we have mentioned it before. okay, the composer Anisa, she's try to establish and exploring the sound of different clarinets. Yeah, the special part of this music is there are no main melody in shoking. The sound is established together and get out one by one, try to create more harmonics. So audience, we not only listen to the notes we are playing. When the sound is crashing together, there are some new harmonics is going to come out.
Well, yeah. It sounds like a fascinating mixture that you've been able to put together all under the theme of sky, but with these very different approaches to the overall theme. Mm. You don't have time to play all of the pieces, of course, here in the studio, but what can you play for us while you're here?
We are going to play two music. The first one is Above the Sky by Fish Yu. It's a very exciting pieces with a lot of runnings and sound building up together to create a big sound. Okay, the second pieces is called Float. The float, the spelling is FLOWNT. The flow is like the flowing, and with the pronunciation of float is floating. So it's about how the music is going to be like. Yeah.
Fascinating. I can't wait to hear it.
Mm. Thank you.
Thank you.